Now, the next type, as you can see, of tense is future perfect tense. Earlier, in earlier video, we have seen future continuous tense. Now, we are going to study about future perfect tense. See, perfect, this tense is also very easy. See, tenses are very easy. Okay? This is also a very easy tense. No confusion, nothing is there in this. Okay? What is the meaning? It tells about the completion of an action in future. Very simple. It tells about the completion of an action in the future. When an action is completed in future, this tense takes place. When we are doing any action in future, and if it is completed then only, then it is known as future perfect tense. Again, the same thing, the rule, will and shall always will be there. Plus have. Perfect mein, remember, you have to use have. Plus the past participle or third form of verb. Past participle or third form of verb. Like this also we write. Third form of verb. This symbol is telling the third form of verb. Okay, so this is the rule of future perfect tense. Will or shall plus have plus past participle or third form of the verb. This V means verb. Okay, now let us see one example. I shall have, I shall have finished my work by 10 a.m. I shall have finished my work by 10 a.m. So here you can see the subject is I. And according to the rule which I told you in the beginning of the class, what do we use? With I we use shall. Shall is there. Okay. The next one is have. Okay. And according to the rule of this perfect tense, ed finishes the main verb. And when we add ed, it becomes finished, which means the third form of the verb. This is the third form of the verb. Okay, my work by 10 a.m. I am talking now, and the work which I shall be doing, it will be finished by 10 a.m. in future. So this is known as future perfect tense, when an action which tells us about the completion of an action in future, the time which tells us about the completion of an action in future, that type of tense or time is known as future perfect tense. See, it's very simple. Let us do one more example. I'm giving you. It's very easy. That example. By the examples only, see, grammar is all full of examples. Okay? As many examples you will do, you will solve. As many as things you will do, practice. That will be more clear and easy for you to learn and understand. Okay? Now, he will have done his work by 9 p.m. according to the rule. Okay, he will have done his work by 9 p.m. See, again, this subject, okay, will, then have, and see, this is the third form of what? Do. Third form of do. Do is the main verb, and this is the third form of do, which is done. Okay, he will have done his work by 9 p.m. So here it is telling an action in future perfect tense, that this is the verb which is completing in future tense by this time, in future by this time. Okay, so this is known as future perfect tense. It's very easy, and when you will do the exercises, we'll solve the exercises, it will be more clear to you. Okay, bye bye.